Good morning students, how are you all? I hope all of you are great. In our previous videos, we have learnt about crop production and management. It was our first lesson. Today we are going to discuss about our second lesson, that is microorganisms, friends and foes. Microorganisms, friends and foes. So first of all, what is meant by microorganism? Microorganisms are the living organism which cannot be seen with naked eyes and can only be observed through a microscope are called microorganisms or microbes. Now next question, where do microorganisms live? Microorganisms are present everywhere. They can live alone while others grow in groups are called colonies. They are found in every kind of environment, air, soil, water. If we will consider water in water bodies, we will consider. So ponds, lakes, sea, river, everywhere microorganisms are found. Actually, microorganisms are found in extreme condition also. Suppose the area which is facing drought, then flood, even hot spring water, polar regions, then deserts, even marshy lands, there also microorganisms found. They survive in extreme environmental conditions by forming a hard outer covering called cyst. Classification of these microorganisms, in four types these microorganisms are classified. First one is the bacteria, second one is the fungi, third one is the protozoa and the last one is the algae. Bacteria, first we will discuss about the bacteria. Bacteria are very small and the simplest living organism. They are single celled organism found almost everywhere. They are found in four different shapes. First one is the bacilli, that is rod shaped, and its example is Escherichia coli. Second one is the cocci, its shape is spherical and its example is Streptococcus pneumonia. Third one is the vibrio. It has the shape comma shaped actually, and its example is Vibrio cholera. The fourth one is the spirilla. Its example is Treponema pacillidum, and it has the shape spiral. Now we will discuss about the aerobic bacteria as well as anaerobic bacteria. Aerobic bacteria are the bacteria which need oxygen for their growth, and anaerobic bacteria are the bacteria which can survive without oxygen for their growth. The mode of nutrition found in bacteria may be autotrophic or heterotrophic. In heterotrophic, they will have the mode of nutrition either saprophytic or parasitic. Saprophytic means they feed on the dead and decaying material, and parasitic means they find out the host which can give them food. This bacteria generally reproduces by binary fission. Now we will move towards the next microorganism, that is fungi. Fungi is a group of diverse organism that is lacking of chlorophyll. You know, they generally grow in dark, moist and warm condition. Most fungi are saprophytes, feed on dead and decaying things, while some are parasites, live on other organisms. Fungi are unicellular, example like yeast, and multicellular like mushrooms. I want to suggest you one activity, students. Take a piece of bread or chapati, just sprinkle little bit water on that chapati or bread and keep it for 24 hours it in a dark place. You will observe green patches on it. So fungi you will observe on that chapati. Now we will move towards our next microorganism, that is protozoa. The word itself tells us, protozoan means first animal, you know. So protozoa are unicellular organism. They are found in ponds, lakes, rivers, sea and damp soil. Protozoa are either saprophytic or parasitic, and the example of this protozoa already you have learned in 7th standard nutrition in amoeba. So amoeba and paramecium are the two examples of protozoa. Now we will move towards our next microorganism, that is algae. Algae is called as seaweeds also. You might have seen algae on the standing water. Green plants are standing there. Actually, it don't have stem, branches, leaves, but it contain chlorophyll, and with this chlorophyll, they can make their own food with photosynthesis. So example of this algae is Spirogyra and Volvox. Now, the next microorganism, which is not included in this four microorganism, it is apart from this, and it is virus. It is microorganism because you can observe it under electron microscope. Okay, the meaning of word virus is poisonous liquid. Generally, it is considered as a non-living thing. Actually, it's link between non-living thing and living thing. Why it is so? Because this virus, it is poisonous liquid, which is covered by a proteinous hard covering. When it is not inside the host body, it act as it is. Okay, there is no chances of its growth or reproduction. But when it is enter in the host body, that is in bacterium, plant cell or animal cell, it takes the energy of that particular cell and its reproduction and growth is taking place. Whatever the energy is present in that cell, it takes all energy of this cell, and the cell either it is dies or it is burst. So in this way, there is reproduction of virus is taking place. They cannot produce their own. The viruses spread and invade the outer cells. Example, vaccinia virus, then influenza virus, HIV virus, and now whatever the pandemic we are facing due to coronavirus, that is also example of a virus. Now we will move towards the usefulness or friendly microorganism. Actually, microorganisms somehow they are useful to us, and some microorganisms they are dangerous to us. First of all, we will discuss about the friendly microorganisms. So microorganisms are useful to us in following ways. First one is the making of food items. Bacteria help us in making certain food items like curd, cheese, then bread and pastries. First of all, we will discuss about the curd. I think you have observed always, curd is the form of milk. Milk is converted into curd. Something is doing, your mother is doing something, then milk is converted into curd. What she is actually doing? She is, the activity I'm going to give you. First of all, I want to discuss, curd contains several microorganisms. Of this, the bacterium, that is lactobacillus bacteria, this lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd. It multiplies in milk and converts it into curd. Now practically, you can do this activity, and you have to do it. Okay, students, take a cup of warm milk, just pour in it 1 teaspoon of curd and keep it aside for the 3-4 hours. After 3-4 hours, you will observe that milk is converted into curd. So this is the activity for your practical knowledge. I am expecting you will do it at home. Now we will move towards bacteria are also involved in the making of cheese, pickles, many other food items. An important ingredient of rava, idli and bhatura is curd. You know, students, curd is using. Bacteria in and yeast are also helpful for fermentation of rice, idlis and dosa batter. Yeast reproduces rapidly and produces carbon dioxide during respiration. Bubbles of the gas fill the dough and increases its volume. On this basis, actually, yeast is used in baking industries for making breads, pastries and cakes. Now we will move towards next use of this bacteria, these microorganisms, that is commercial use. Commercial use means, with the help of this bacteria, we can earn money. Okay, that is commercial use. The meaning of commercial use. It is used for commercial production of alcohol, beer, wine and acetic acid. You know, students, acetic acid, your mother is using when she's prepare Chinese food, she's using vinegar. You know, students, that vinegar means nothing but acetic acid. The chemical name of vinegar is acetic acid. So for this, its production of acetic acid also there is use of yeast. The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol by the action of microbes like yeast is called fermentation. Fermentation is the process in which the sugar is converted into alcohol with the help of microbes, that is microorganism, and that process is called as fermentation. Some bacteria are useful in the production of tea, coffee and tobacco. Some bacteria take part in the production of acids like lactic acid. Lactic acid is present in curd. Citric acid. Citric acids are present in citrus food. Examples are orange, lemon and acetic acid. Acetic acid is nothing but a vinegar. Okay. So these were the uses of microorganisms in terms of commercial use. Now we will move towards the medicinal use of this microorganisms. Some of the medicinal use of microorganisms are production of antibiotics. Students, do you know what is meant by antibiotics? Antibiotics are the medicines which are prepared from the microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi, which kill or stop the growth of disease causing microorganisms. So that is pathogens present in our body are called antibiotics. Example, streptomycin, tetramycin. So have you understood what is meant by antibiotics? Antibiotics are the medicines which are prepared from the with the help of bacteria or fungi, and when we intake that antibiotics, they are stop or they are killing the bacteria which are disease causing bacteria, that is pathogen, and this medicine is called as antibiotics. Now antibiotics are useful, of course, antibiotics are useful, but the way you are using antibiotics, and I think in India, without thinking they are using. I have discussed with my sister, she is in Australia, and she is telling me in out of countries, generally in Europe countries, that doctors are very easily not prescribed you antibiotics because it has the advantage, but simultaneously its disadvantages are more. So we have to very conscious, we have to take precautions while using this antibiotics. So what we are supposed to do, very first thing, antibiotics should be taken only by the advice of a qualified doctor. So it's very necessary, students. Second thing, we must complete the entire course of antibiotics prescribed by the doctor. I have lots of time observed some people, doctors are prescribed them antibiotics, they are taking one or two dose of that antibiotics and they felt that now I'm feeling better, and they stop taking that antibiotics. This is my humble request to all of you, my students, parents and those watching my videos. Actually, it is very harmful. It is not a exact way to take antibiotics. Whatever the dose are prescribed by your doctor, you are supposed to take that complete dose. Now, third is that we should not take antibiotics when not needed or in wrong doses. The same thing, whatever I told you, students, antibiotics taken unnecessarily may kill the beneficial bacteria which are present in our stomach, in our intestine. So wisely take that antibiotics, and if it is very, very essential, that time only you are supposed to take the antibiotics. In the case of cold and flu, should not take antibiotics, because there is no any antibiotics which is useful in the case of cold and flu. Now we will move towards the uses of bacteria in medical field. Actually, second use, first one we have seen that antibiotics, production of antibiotics, and second one is the production of vaccines. So vaccines are different from the antibiotics. Actually, first of all, I want to ask you the what is meant by immunity. Immunity is the ability of one's body to resist डिसीज इज नोन एज इम्यूनिटी, मीन्स इट इज द रेजिस्टेंस पावर ऑफ अवर बॉडी विच इज फाइटिंग विद द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म विच आर कैरिंग डिसीजेस, यू नो. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इम्यूनिटी. इम्यूनिटी अगेंस्ट अ पर्टिकुलर डिसीज कैन बी डेवलप्ड बाय अ टेक्निक कॉल्ड वैक्सीनेशन. सो वैक्सीनेशन इज अ टेक्निक, इट इज द टेक्निक डेवलप्ड बाय डॉक्टर्स एंड इट गिव्स यू इम्यूनिटी, इट गिव्स यू रेजिस्टेंस पावर to fight against the microorganism, and it is vaccine means particular disease, the particular disease has the particular vaccine. Now a small dose of dead and weakened disease causing microbes used to stimulate immune response in the body is called vaccine. So what is actual process? Vaccine is the it is the medicine in which the bacteria are used. But the bacteria means that disease causing bacteria, but that bacteria are they are killed bacteria or weakened bacteria. What happened that time? Our body starting fighting against it, and antibodies are produced in our body, and it remains forever. So whenever such a type of microorganisms enters in our body, means that is infected of particular diseases, our body is having the antibodies, and they are fight with that micro disease causing microorganisms or micro that is bacteria. Its example, vaccines example I'm giving you, the vaccines are available for the cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox, tetanus, hepatitis B, can be prevented by vaccination. Now we will move towards the next use of this microorganism, that is increasing soil fertility. Okay, so in our previous lesson already we have seen that the crop production and management, and in that lesson already I have taught you the topic for replenishment of the soil. We are using the manures, fertilizers. So manures are the organic waste. Okay students, it increase the soil fertility. So in this case, how bacteria are useful? We have learnt about rhizobium bacteria, you know. These are found on the root nodules of leguminous plants. It absorb nitrogen gas from the atmosphere and it convert that nitrogen gas into soluble nitrates. Okay students, after harvesting, when the roots decompose, the nitrates present in the root nodules mix the soil and enrich it with the nitrogenous compound and hence increase the soil fertility. And that's why experts are advised to farmers in a year at once they are supposed to take the crop of leguminous plants, and due to this simultaneously there is increase in fertility of the soil due to this rhizobium bacteria. Some bacteria and blue green algae living in soil also fix this atmospheric nitrogen as nitrates. These are called commonly biological nitrogen fixers. Now we will move towards the next use of microorganism, that is cleaning the environment. So you will have the question, how these microorganisms are helpful for the cleaning the environment? It's quite natural, students. So whatever naturally you can found on this earth, it has link, you know, students. So the microorganisms decompose dead organic waste of plants and animals by covering them into harmless simpler substances which are restored to the soil and increase its fertility. I want to elaborate it with the example of manure. You might have seen the gardeners are using the plant waste as well as animal waste. They are digging a pit and they are pouring these things, this plant waste and animal waste in that pit, and they leave it for some days, might be month or 15 days or 30 days. In that between, this plant waste and animal waste are converted into organic manure, which is very very helpful. And first of all, it cleans environment, means whatever the waste material, it was collected by that gardener, a farmer, and they are keeping it in a pit, and they are forming they are converting it into as a manure. So what happened? what ultimately they have cleaned the environment. Some other uses of microbes we can discuss, students. Bacteria are useful in leather and jute industries. So in leather industry, it is used as tanning, and in jute industry, we have seen the leather industry, now jute industries, this separation of fibers is also done by the action of bacteria. So bacteria are also helps in generating biogas, you know, students, digestion of cellulose in ruminants. So this one also you have studied in 7th standard, digestive system in ruminants. And ruminants are digesting cellulose because the specific bacteria present in their stomach, and they digest that cellulose. That bacteria are not present in human beings, so we could not digest cellulose. Okay, students, so this was the half part of our lesson. And we have studied about the microorganisms, their types, as well as their uses.